Well, hi there. I'm coming to you from what I call the silly tree. And I call it that because we typically think of a tree as something that grows straight up towards the sky. And yet this tree has taken a slightly different bent on life. This tree has sent out branches in every different direction. They are twisted and coiled, and it is completely a silly mess. And yet, in all of its imperfection, it is strangely beautiful because it is an example of a tree that is striving and trying and doing everything that it can to live and to spread its branches and to get as far as it can go. And I couldn't help but think about the church. We are talking today in our 9-week study on the God of the Impossible. This is a supplement for our life group lesson. And we started last week with the God of the Impossible and the God of my plans. And today we're talking about the God of my church. And so I wanted to share with you Colossians chapter 1, verses 24 through 29, some very powerful words from the Apostle Paul concerning his service to the church. And so I wanted to share that with you as a challenge today. Colossians chapter 1, verse 24, Paul says this, "Now I rejoice in what was suffered for you, and I fill up in my flesh what is still lacking in regard to Christ's afflictions for the sake of his body, which is the church. I have become its servant by the commission God gave me to present to you the word of God in its fullness." Now let's stop right there. Paul is telling us that A, the church was not free. It came at a great and tremendous cost to Christ Jesus. That the cost is still ongoing because there are those like him who are still suffering to make sure that the church continues, and that he was commissioned by God for his position in the church. He believed fully that God ordained that he would be part of the church. Those are important points. He goes on to say, "The mystery that has been kept hidden for all ages and generations, but is now disclosed to the saints." This is what we're doing. We are teaching and showing the world this great mystery of God's wisdom. He says, "To them God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory." So he's telling you that the church is actually you, the body, that Christ in you makes up the body of Christ. So the church is made up of body of believers. He goes on to say, "We proclaim him, admonishing and teaching everyone with all wisdom, so that we may present everyone perfect in Christ. To this end I labor, struggling with all his energy, which so powerfully works in me." He is admitting that here on this side of heaven, we will not reach perfection, but we are striving, we are struggling, we are working very hard, much like this silly tree. And there is a great beauty within the church if you are willing to look past its flaws and look past its humanity and look at Christ and look at what Christ has done for us. Look at what Christ did to create this church. And then rather than complain about the church all the time, we can come to the church with rejoicing and we can say, "Praise you, Jesus, for dying on the cross to create this glorious, blessed church, this hope of the world, whereby we can be a body of believers that is stretching, that is learning, that is growing, that is reaching." See, this is what the church is. We are not perfect yet, but we are striving for it. We are striving for the Savior to reach as many of the lost as can be reached, and to transform the way we all think so that we become more perfect, and to help us become more holy so that we are like Christ, so that we can then know the will of God and we can continue to stretch and reach and go and do what we have been called to do. And so today I want to end with one simple question, but a challenging one. Week 2, the God of my church, here's your challenge question, and we'll discuss this again Sunday in Life Group. What is the single greatest thing you could do to strengthen your church, your congregation? What is the single greatest thing you could do to strengthen your church? And I pray that God will bless you with a great answer.